Hello guys, my name is Kapil and today we are going to talk about how you can count these cells based on some criteria in an Excel file. Yes, so we are going to talk about how you can use Countif or Countifs function in an Excel file. Before I start, I request you to subscribe my YouTube channel and click on below bell icon to get the notifications for new updates. So let's start. So Countif and Countifs. So we need to understand that in Countif and Countifs, there is a very slight difference in the arguments. When you start write Countif and bracket on, and you can see there is only two arguments. One is range, second is the criteria. Range means the criteria range, from where you want to calculate the count of cells based on this criteria. So we will be writing Countif, bracket on, then range. So we need to select the range. So here I'm going to select sales rep, and if you see here, I selected the sales rep range. Once I'm fixing it, I want to calculate how many times David appeared in this range. So let me write this David and now bracket off. Once you press enter, you can see there are 5 times when David is appearing in this range. Okay, now suppose if David is written in any other cell, so how you can calculate that? You just remove this David and just link it to this cell, it will calculate H2. So that is how you can count these cell of numbers based on one criteria. But there are some cases when you want to calculate the numbers of cells based on the multiple criteria. In that case, what we need to do, we need to use Countifs function. So both contain the same logic, only the arguments change slightly. Okay, it shows criteria range 1, then criteria 1, then criteria range 2, and so on. So that is how you can use Countif function. So what you need to do, you just select the first range. Okay, once you select this range, you need to fix this. Then second is the criteria. Criteria could be this H2. So in this range, I am calculating how many times David appeared. But suppose now if I want to calculate how many times David made these sales in particular country. So in that case, what I'll be doing, I'll be selecting the country range, I'll be fixing it, then I'll be going back and I need to write either manually in the inverted comma Australia, or I can write in any other cell and I can link this particular argument to that cell. Now I'm entering it. Now you can see it is showing 2. Now suppose if I write the condition here Australia, and if I go back and I link this last argument to this cell and I press enter, show the same result. So that is what we need to understand. Now second thing, that whenever you write the Countifs function or Countif function, you need to remember that the ranges you select, the criteria range, it should always be same. What I mean by same, it should start from the same row and ends at same row. And if you are calculating in a column, then you need to make sure that it is starting from the same column and ending at the same column. So now you can see that I am calculating the count of cells in a vertical manner. So I need to make sure that it starts from the same row. So it is starting from 2, ending at 49th row. And here also it is starting from 2nd row and ending at 49th row. So suppose if I write it 48, enter, it will show me an error. So we need to make sure both the ranges where we are checking the criteria should be same. Hope you understand this concept. Now guys, I'm going to talk about a master trick. So now we are going to calculate the count of cells between a date range or between a range. So now you can see that I have a sales volume data. In this sales volume data, you can see I have the dates and the sales rep and the countries. So now suppose if I want to calculate the sales made between a particular period by one sales rep or in one country, how I can do this with the help of Countifs function. So before that, I need to write the criteria. So I'll be writing from date to date. Between these two dates, I will be finding the sales made. Okay, so now I want to calculate the sales made between 1st January 2020, so ending at 31st of January 2020. Before that, I need to write the criteria in which I want to calculate the count of cells. So I'm writing from date and to date, and between these two dates, I will be finding the count of cells or count of sales made between this period. Now I'm typing Countifs, now bracket on. So first criteria will be the sales rep. I need to fix this by pressing F4, then comma, and then criteria. So criteria is debit. So I want to see in January how many times debit made the sales. So I will be clicking on this debit, and then it is asking for the criteria range too. So what I'll be doing, I will be going here, I'll be selecting the date range, I'll be fixing this, and I will be clicking comma, and then now you can see criteria 2. In the criteria 2, I'll be writing from date. So I'll be using logical operators in the inverted comma to calculate the sales made between a date range. Okay, so now here you can see inverted comma, then greater than sign and equal to sign. So what I typed, inverted comma, greater than, equal to, and then inverted comma closed, and then I'm using this and to connect it with the from date. So now what I'm doing, I'm just selecting the from date cell. Now I'll be typing comma, and now we'll be giving this third criteria. So third criteria is the to date. So we need to select the criteria range 3 again, the date range. Once we select it, we need to fix this by pressing F4, then comma. Now we need to give the criteria. So in the criteria, we need to type the logical operators again in the inverted comma. So lesser than sign, equal to sign, and then inverted comma. Okay. And now pressing and selecting the criteria 3 and pressing enter. Now you can see there are 4 times in this date David made the sales. So that is how you can calculate the count of sales between a date range. Here we need to understand what we did. We just simply gave the criteria for David. We just typed the sales rep range and then just gave the criteria, which is H2 cell. It contains David. So it will be checking how many times debit appeared in this particular cell. Now in the second criteria range, we type the date range where we are checking the count of cells which is greater than or equal to this particular date, from date. So suppose if I want to calculate the count of cells which is greater than this particular date, I can remove this, and then if I press enter, it will say 5. So it is calculating whatever date is greater than to 1st of January, it is calculating all those cells. Now let me undo this. In the third criteria, we are saying in this particular date range, how many times David made these sales, which is lesser than this date or equal to this date. So that is how you should use Countifs function to count the number of cells between a date range. In the Countif function also, you can use the same logic, but in Countif function, you can only give one criteria. You cannot give multiple criteria. So that is why we use Countifs function to use this. So now, suppose if you want to calculate the count of cells between a date range and you don't want to use this equal to sign. So what you can do, you just keep it as greater than and lesser than. And now here you can mention -1. -1 is calculating the one date prior to 1st of January. So it will take 1st of January into the consideration while calculating the count of cells between this date range. Here also you can write +1. I hope that you understand this concept to calculate the count of cells between a date range. So now guys, what we are going to do, we are going to learn how these logical operators are going to work. Okay, so there are two kind of logical operators. One is related to the numbers or dates, and second is related to the any alphanumeric or text, you can say. So I created this small information for you on this slide. So now you can see my screen. On this, on the top, you are seeing different symbols like greater than, lesser than, and greater than and equal to. So these are related to the number. So whenever you want to count these cells which are greater than or lesser than, you will be typing these symbols like this. In the inverted comma, you will be entering the greater than sign or lesser than sign, and then you will be connecting with the and sign and then the cell reference. Similarly, you will be going to do this for the greater than and equal to. So whenever you want to use this combination, you will be putting it into the inverted commas, greater than and equal to sign, then and symbol, and then the cell reference. Similarly for the lesser than. Here you can just remember one thing, equal to sign will always come on the right side, okay, but in the same inverted comma, I should say. Okay, then you will be connecting with the and sign, then the H2.
Okay, and whenever you want to calculate something between a range, between a date range or between a number range, you can use the combination of these. Okay, like greater than or equal to or lesser than or greater than. That is how you can use different combinations. And also I want to tell you that this is universal. In any Excel function, if you have similar situation, you can use these logical operators in the same way. Okay. Now we are going to learn how you can count the cells based on the text when it is not exactly matching. What do I mean by this? Okay. So whenever you want to count the cells in a range which contains particular text, in that case, you will be using this star logical operator. Okay. Or you want to count these cells which starts with, which begins with a particular text, but you don't want to put the entire text, then you can use this star logical operator. Similarly, you can do it when any text is ending with particular text. Okay. So let's understand this in detail. What do I mean? So when you want to count these cells which contains particular text, okay, you will be putting the star at the beginning and star at the end, and in between you will be entering the cell reference and you will be connecting again with the end sign. So in the inverted comma, you will be putting star symbol, then end symbol, then H2, then end symbol, then inverted comma and star sign. And again inverted comma closed. So it is for when you want to count the cells which contains particular text. Okay, if you want to count the cells which begins with particular text, you can use cell reference and then end sign, and at the end you will be putting the star symbol in the inverted comma. Similarly, you will be doing for ends with. In the ends with, you will be putting the star symbol in the inverted comma at the beginning, and then you'll be connecting it with the end sign and then the cell reference. So now let's use this in the countifs function. So now suppose if you want to use like POR, okay, so I'm just putting it like this, and now you want to count these cells which contains this POR in this country column. Okay, you will be selecting the country range. You can select the entire range or you can select the particular range. Then you will be making this absolute cell reference by pressing F4. Okay. Once you do this, then comma, then criteria. Now, as I told you, when you want to calculate something which contains, okay, you will be putting the star symbol at the beginning, then end sign, then POR, then again you will be putting end sign, and then connecting with the end sign, and then again putting the star symbol. Now you can close it. Now press enter. Now you can see 7 times this POR words occur in this particular range. Basically it is Singapore. Okay, so that is how you can calculate countifs. For begins with, like if something starts with SING, okay, let's do it for Singapore again. Criteria range, you will be selecting the range, fixing it by F4, then comma, then criteria 1. Okay. In the criteria 1, you will be like, either you can connect it with the cell reference or you can type it in the inverted comma, sing. Okay. But before that, I need to put, because I am just calculating begins with. So sing in the beginning, then end sign, then entering the star symbol, and then bracket off and entering. Now you can see the numbers are same. Okay, this is for SING. And now again, if you want to count these cells based on the ends with, you can select the range, fix it. So it is not necessary to fix it. It is just for your reference that if you want to use the absolute cell reference or relative, it depends on your condition. So just put it criteria range, then the criteria 1. In the criteria 1, you will be putting a star sign and then and sign, and then you can mention P-O-R-E and then press enter. Okay. If you want to use some multiple criterias, then in the criteria 1, okay, it is done. Put comma, and then in criteria range 2, you can calculate how many times David has made these sales. Just do it. F4, then comma criteria 2, as it is asking here, you can see it gets highlighted here, David, bracket off, then enter. So it shows error. It means that David doesn't appear in the Singapore. Okay, so you can use some other name like Rudy. So now, oh, again it is showing error. So the reason is, as I told you earlier, that the range should always be same. So it is not same. So let me do it. B2. Okay. Then dollar, again I'm putting it 49 and then pressing enter. Now you can see it has counted the number. Okay. Perhaps it would have also counted the David also, because I didn't put the range correctly. So David, I put it and it is also counting. So David is also making some sale in Singapore. So that is how you are going to use this countifs function. Hope you understood this concept now very well. And you can just comment here if you have any questions. Thank you for watching this video. Please share this with your friends. Have a great day. Bye-bye.